What do people continue to work even after they retire?
Today we're finding out if the side hustle is for you. Our money expert Dustin Smith from Wealth Enhancement Group joins us live. Dustin, we're seeing more and more people in their retirement years going ahead and picking up that little side hustle.
Sure, absolutely. I mean, right now.
Yeah, is this about money or is this about having something to do?
I think it's a little bit of both, to be fair. You know, I think for a lot of people, when you retire, unless you've really scheduled out how you plan to spend your time, stopping working cold turkey is really tough to do. I mean, I think people spend maybe the first 1 or 2 months in retirement without working. They go, gosh, this is really nice. But after a while, they go, gosh, how am I going to spend my time? And they miss, you know, having coworkers. They miss having a place to go. So I think, you know, in a lot of ways, the side hustle is maybe more for emotional benefit than just monetary gains.
And it seems like the nature of the work is changing a little bit so that it might be an option for more people. Say, you know, I know there are some retirees that go into being an Uber driver or a Lyft driver.
For sure. And I think it's because it's easier to do so than ever. I mean, we all know someone who, for example, decided to drive Uber simply because one day they said, gosh, you know, I got a car, I got all this extra time, and it's easy to sign up for Uber. Why not try it? Because you get to work when you want. And I think that's so good for people because, you know, often people did not want to get some sort of part-time job, let's say at a retail store, for example, because they said, gosh, I don't want to work weekends. I don't want to work on the holidays. But places like Uber or, you know, delivering groceries allow people to work at their own schedule.
Is there a potential negative to this? Can this affect your other retirement benefits that you might have coming to you?
Sure, it can affect things to some extent. So for example, let's say you are 62 years old and you decide to draw Social Security in retirement. The amount of benefit that you receive can actually be reduced if you make too much money on some sort of side job, for example. So you want to be thoughtful of that. Also, you know, if you're making a lot of extra money, it could affect things like your Medicare premium and the taxation, obviously, on all your other assets. But that being said, last time I checked, there isn't a 100% tax rate. So typically, if you work, you'll usually come out ahead, even if though you're paying some taxes.
Yeah. You also say plan ahead. What should we need to plan for?
Yeah, so if you've never had a part-time, let's say, side job, you've never had to probably set aside money to pay for taxes or track expenses. And that can really catch up to people after their first year of doing this work when they go to do their taxes and they realize, oh my gosh, I owe all this money. I didn't know. So if you are planning to have some sort of side job, whether it be, you know, you're taking your hobby to the next level or what have you, talk with one of your accountants or tax preparers and just simply say, gosh, you know, this is about how much I'm making. These are my expenses. And they will give you some tips and tricks to make sure that you're paying in maybe quarterly correctly or tracking your expenses so you don't get a big surprise at the end of the year.
Smart. Good for folks to have that extra mental activity. And it's terrific that people have more options now. Dustin, thank you.